We ran out of medals again. Let's go. I'm getting so super. Oh my goodness, let's go. Did you see that, dude? Thank goodness for rubber shields. We are not losing. Let's do that.
Hey guys, thank you so much for tuning in today, and today we're talking about a scout rifle that's not really talked about a lot. I've been using this for quite a while, so I think I have a pretty good understanding of how to use it and how it works, and more importantly, how it defeats enemies. So the Crucible kill shows I have 246, but actually I have a lot more than this because of I just recently put it on, and of course this is the Distant Relation. If you've watched some of my other videos, you know I use this quite a bit. So now I'm going to go into an in-depth perk description of what all the scout rifle comes with. Of course, these come with random rolls, but let's see what I got, because this thing really destroys. Very first thing you have, it's chambered barrel or small bore. I put on small bore just because honestly, it just kind of feels better. It's more smooth, especially when I talk about later when you have to strafe around. It's really easy to use. Tactical mag, you want to focus on reloading because of the triple tac perk instead of extended mag. It only increases by like 2 or 3, and you want that stability and reload speed. Next is triple tap. So rapidly landing a precisionist will turn one round to the magazine, which really works good with explosive payload because projectiles create an area of effect that detonate on impact, aka you shoot them in the body. It might count as a crit with the explosion damage, and when you get that triple tap, aka 3 hits, it'll give you back a bullet. So you can shoot basically like 20 some odd bullets per magazine if you're hitting your shots. And actually, in the clip I'm about to show you, it doesn't take a whole lot to actually take down it. And the reason why it looks a bit different is because I'm using an ornament. So if you were wondering. So this is my general build, and I actually have no actual upgrades. As you can see here, a quick run over of my perks. I have nothing that's upgrading my distant relation other than that targeting adjuster directly on it. For my primary, of course, I'm using chaperone because you have to take out those enemies to get close to you. And for your heavy ammo, it really doesn't matter whatsoever. Use whatever you feel comfortable with. Yeah, but Distant Relation is just a beast seen in those images. Yes, it has some flaws, like, you know, obviously it can't take out people who are really close to you, but it's used as a fear tactic, and it does a ton of damage, and you can also shoot people from, like, insane distances. Like, right here, look, I shot the back of the wall, and it actually took him out because of the area of explosive damage. Somebody's hiding behind cover, boom, you'll take him out. So this is a full game mode of me using a distant relation. I feel like I chose this clip because of I actually use it a lot. Most of the time, I'm actually using Chaperone because I'm very well acquainted with Chaperone and I love using it. But this is just a really good match in order to show how good distant relation is. In the clip, I do end up getting we ran out of medals. But every single time I've gotten a we ran out of medals, it was actually because of I was using this and Chaperone. Yeah, so if you want to begin trying out scout rifles, I would definitely try giving this thing a try. As you can see here, I was taking out snipers without problem, taking down a lot of people without problems. Yeah, it doesn't do a whole lot of, like, a lot of damage, but it's definitely a good scout rifle to use. I got all my scout rifle kills for Randy's throwing knife using this thing, and I wasn't even really going for it all the way. And if you don't believe me, honestly, just check out my other clips. I love using distant relation. It's definitely my favorite scout. I would prefer this thing over Randy's any day. Yeah, but if you really want to see more action, if this video doesn't convince you, just feel free to try out looking at some of my other videos. I use it sometimes way better than I do in this game. But yeah, so it's really good to use. It's definitely a fear tactic weapon. Definitely give it a try if you're going for scout rifles. I hope you guys have a good rest of the day. If you enjoyed this video, feel free to slap a like button on it and subscribe as well. And if you feel like it, maybe one of your friends is going after Randy or something and could find this video useful, feel free to share that with him or her. And I hope you guys have a good rest of the day. Really, that's all I have to say. Peace.
Kill him, dude. Oh, I got that super, by the way. I already used my super. I got a kill with it too. I killed the super. Oh shoot, they're taking all of our zones. Okay, never mind. We held it. Oh, dude. Toby, you took it for me there again. The last one's probably an error. Watch out, there's a super. Thank you. No, it's just the fact that every single person uses it. Hey, can I have help? Here at sea. We ran out of medals again. Let's go. I'm not challenging that. Dang it! Ugh. They teamed me. I got attacked from behind and then I got...
It's all about humanity.
Place, bro. I do not stay in one place. I move around. Hey, whoever, Colby, come here. Come to me. Hey, I'm under fire. Oh my gosh. Dude, this Titan, dude. He missed the melee charge. But then he freaked me out. And... Hey, by the way, they're going A. They're going A.
It's all about humanity.
No, I'm gonna get killed, bro. Oh my gosh, this stupid thank you for killing me. Stupid Zoomer. Freaking just shoulder charging everybody.
It's all about humanity.
Why is everybody focusing on me? What the heck? I've only spawned 3 times in a row. And get instantly blade barraged. And Nova bombed. I got solo Nova bombed, dude. I got the rerunner. Let's go, dude. Let's go. There you go, boys.